Professor Lanike Adeyemo. I'm the Deputy Vice Chancellor, Research, Innovation and Strategic Partnerships, University of Ibadan. The idea of our geo-hackathon started like a joke, but it's something that has become very, 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 very important in the scheme of things. When I became the Deputy Vice Chancellor, the pioneer Deputy Vice Chancellor, Research, Innovation and Strategic Partnerships, one day, a young man, Mr. Atolu Afolayo, walked into my office to intimate me of an existing donation by Esri to the University of Ibadan. If we are aware, GIS technology is just the way, same way computer used to be some 20, 30 years ago. GIS technology is something that is very, very useful. If you hear GIS, you think just geography, but it's very applicable across board, across all disciplines. And we had this software within the University of Ibadan, all the complement of it, and we were just not using it. And it was coming up for renewal, and we had to do something fast. And so that was one of the things that we did, was to build a concept around it. Apart from that, the idea of the Academe is supposed to be a place where we provide solutions to societal problems. And so we came up with this idea to use the GIS technology to drive multidisciplinary collaboration, to drive a sustainable solution to societal problems, since it's so applicable across board. And one of the first things we started was that, okay, we have this technology. Apart from people in geography, some other people in other departments, faculties, might not actually know how to effectively deploy the GIS software. And so we started to look partnered with us. We signed an MOU with GIS Consult Limited, Tolu Afolayo, started training across faculty, departments, students. We had boot camp for students. And so after we had a wide group of people within the university community that were able to actually effectively deploy this, then we went to the next stage, multidisciplinary collaboration. How do we drive that? We thought of the geo-hackathon to give them a challenge to say, okay, so provide some solution to this particular challenge. And the first one held last year, it was around the convocation period. And we had fantastic ideas from our students. There was a group of girls who, in India, all picked up all the nylon waste and they made towels from it. There was another person that actually did something which was very, very useful. When you are pumping water in the house, most of the time you put on your pumping machine and then you go inside and then the water continues to waste and flood the environment. But this device is able to, once the tank is filled, it automatically, like a sensor, shuts down the water and the pumping process. So we had like about 10 or so of such fantastic idea. There was a kidnap alert. So many of those that came up from that challenge. And so one of the people that partnered with us at that time that supported the initiative was Ibadan Urban Flood Management Project. Ibadan Urban Flood Management Project is Oyo State project, which is World Bank assisted. So we, after the geo-hackathon, we were very impressed and the World Bank people came to the University of Ibadan. Apparently, they have all this data from the project that has been on for years. They have these GIS laboratories within the Oyo State government, and they felt that the university could partner with them to actually deploy some of these the laboratories to train and retrain, build capacity within the Oyo State ministries. And then so we started with an MOU with IUFMP and decided that this year's geo-hackathon, which is the second season, was going to be built around urban resilience. And we're going to use the projects, all the outcome, all the gaps, and all the things that we think are problems that we think we can provide solutions to drive the geo-hackathon season 2. And so we are starting off this, and I'm very sure the students of the University of Ibadan, like I always say, they are the cream de la cream of the student body of Nigeria. And this is a challenge to our students, to our staff, to our faculties, to technologists within the University of Ibadan. As we start the geo-hackathon season 2, working towards the hackathon, it's about urban resilience. We are starting off on the 5th of October with a workshop to actually showcase for the Oyo State IUFMP project to come and show us what they have, the master plan, where they think that the problems are the challenge. And then it's now on us to actually look at it and using GIS technology, provide the necessary solution. And I'm very, very assured, I'm very sure our students are up to the task, our staff are up to the task. What is the essence of Academe? It's about providing the support to the immediate community. We want to provide support. We want to drive development in Oyo State and in Nigeria in general. And I think this is something that Geo Hackathon is able to do for us.